How do you think VR movies will look like? Is there such a thing as a VR movie even?
I don't think we're going to call them movies. I think there's going to be experiences that are going to be more or less interactive. So it's going to be, you know, movies and video games and everything in between, but we're not going to call them movies anymore. There are so many fascinating things that are going to happen. First of all, I think they're going to be way more interactive than they are right now. Immersive, of course, you're going to feel like you're inside of the film, but you're going to start to have characters that react to you, characters that are AI driven, and when you actually do something, they react to your emotions.
Well, in a lot of ways, we have this in computer games today, right?
Yes.
I mean, in a somewhat really smart, primitive way,
exactly.
But...
In the future, so what I see is that we're not going to be filming the real world anymore. Like in about 8 to 10 years, everything's going to be CGI generated. You're not going to be able to tell the difference between that and like virtual and real. So everything we're going to do with a computer, so we can do it, so it can be modified in real time. And you're going to be able to, like, to change the background and change the sky, and the characters are going to react to you. And one thing that we're working on, and which I believe is going to be the absolute future of entertainment, is what we call reactive content. So it's content that is not only interactive because you have an input and you do something, but also because it knows who you are. So you'll add inputs like your age, your sex, your location, what colors you love, what kind of music. We're going to analyze your Spotify and say, you know what, for this piece in which we want like relaxing music, let's analyze what music you listen to after 8 p.m., which is when you finish work, and then put something that is similar to that as a background music.
So VR today is the typically tethered headset. It's pretty clunky, like it's not super comfortable to wear for like really long periods of time. It's kind of antisocial. Like, what do you think the hardware side of it, where does that evolve? Because it needs to evolve, right? I really can't see us like wearing these things.
100%.
Like,
it's just a matter of how much time it's going to take. What I see is, first of all, what I see is that there's not going to be a difference between AR and VR. You know, we continue doing, you know, saying like VR is dead because AR is on, it's the same thing. It's just how many layers you have in front of reality. So same device, that's for sure. Same kind of content, same platforms. Eventually that will evolve to contact lenses, something like very light. And eventually what I think it makes more sense. So we try to emulate how we feel. We're using a lot of haptic technologies to, you know, to feel, to, but like the whole body, that's a pretty big organ. It's very difficult to mimic how you feel by touching, smelling, hearing. What I feel is that it's way easier once we solve how the brain works. It's going to be way easier to tap into our optical nerve and say to the brain, this is what you need to see. And that's what I envision the future of VR to be. That's, I don't know, 25, 30 years, but it's going to happen.
This is a conversation about VR. It's important, I think it's important to understand, like, it's not a conversation about just storytelling and media. And you actually made an interesting, bold statement where you said that you predict that VR will affect half the world's industry within a decade. Can you elaborate a little bit on this? Like, what does this mean?
Well, first of all, there is a lot of industries that are directly affected by it, like medicine or education or transportation, but teaching people how to use things, entertainment for sure. So all of those are gonna get disrupted by VR because it makes more sense to experience those things in VR. It's cheaper to produce, you can massively put it out there, you can learn way more, and it enhances our human experience. At the same time, I think VR has the capability to start changing our minds, to start changing who we are as human beings. And this is, again, getting deep into philosophical realm, but in the end, it's like when you're if I'm able to transport you to 2,000 years ago and trick your brain into thinking you're actually there, and you spend there like 5 hours or 12 hours or 5 days, for your brain, you've actually been there. So you've traveled back in time. I can also do that forward.
Right.
I can connect you with beings that you loved that are not there anymore. So reality becomes something that, you know, is not so certain. And that will definitely affect how we see the world, how we connect with each other. It's the same thing that happens with psychedelics. Like, it's like a different reality that shows you things that you wouldn't even think they existed. And it will give you a different perspective on life, on who you are, on where we... I always use this example. Like, since the invention of the microscope, we didn't know that in every cell of our scene there is, there was a million other beings. Same with the telescope. We thought we were the center of the universe until we got technology to see there was something else. So I feel VR is gonna make us reassess who we are, and that will obviously impact social, political, every kind of thing.
All right, let me ask you one last personal question. And it's a yes or no answer.
Okay.
So with everything we have talked about, is this here already a simulation, or is this real as in real?
The answer, I would say, the short is yes. The slightly longer is we have way many more chances of being a simulation than not. I want to believe.